homestand is just seconds over, and the road trip is begun. The weight of a 5-4 loss to the Rangers is heavier because it was at home, but it's also history. And win, lose, or draw, the preparations must continue. In fact, such as trainer Jerry Dean might not even be aware of the score of this night, for he has been and is preoccupied. Make the getaway smoothly, quickly, efficiently.
We pack it very systematically, reorganized so we can get it all in. And that we have the trunks at the back, so they go on the aircraft first, because the pilots and the people can pack it better out there at the airport.
Players must cooperate too. We're less than 10 minutes after the game and it's all done.
Yeah, Kenny pulls out the bags, or I pull out the bags, and we lay it all systematically, and they throw it all in, and they're very well organized.
It's a make or break it on this road trip. I think that's the way we're looking at it anyways. We got to go out there and play 60 minutes of hockey, grind them right out, and play the best we can. And we've got to come out over 500 this trip if we want to be anywhere in the standings.
You always go on the road with optimism, despite the fact that we've had a tough time on the road over a couple of years. But I know our team and the coaches always go on feeling like this is going to be the time that we turn it around. And in this particular trip, because we were in Calgary with a chance to catch up on them a little bit, I think there's extra room for optimism. And plus the fact that we are in a little desperate situation here, I think we all feel like we can do it, and this will be the time.
It's approaching midnight Saturday. The days of the week mean nothing during the season. Sunday's pregame meal is no different, simply 6 hours before game time.
We try and plan it conveniently after the morning skate. And some players like to have steak and some fish and chicken. And it's just a more or less a superstition or preference for what you like to eat, more than, you know, you're getting more carbohydrates and that'll give you energy and that kind of thing. It's just more or less what you like to eat.
For Garrett's new roommate, it's an important road trip. It's his first with Vancouver.
This road trip is great. It's a good start. I'm on the road. You get to meet the guys, get a feel for how everyone plays. There's not the pressure of having to produce right in front of the home crowd right away, because I wasn't playing a lot in Boston. It's going to take me a few games to get things, hopefully get things going. So all in all, it was numbing at first, but it's becoming more and more exciting.
The game day rituals continue. And yet another bus ride. Never mind the hundreds as a junior, as many a game for the veteran pros. The scenery is redundant, academic. Alberta is home to some. For Easterners, Westerners, and Europeans alike, tonight it's the home of the adversary. The Calgary Flames have been a nemesis for the Canucks at the Pacific Coliseum, the Corral, or the Saddle Dome.
We have to overcome the little black cloud that is over our heads regarding them. Our record is terrible since we've beaten them out 2 years ago in the playoffs. They've had it all over us like a tent. We really have had trouble with them. So I think we've got to try and get our own confidence level up right away by looking sharp. That would be my goal for our team, is to come out right away and look sharp and be confident and look like we're going to be able to do it. And then that will grow as we go on. If we come out and stumble a bit and are non-confident or fighting the puck a bit, then the opposite will happen. Our lack of confidence will multiply. So just being alert and sharp right away will be the big thing for us, I think.
Funnily enough, some road trips that you enter into and you're not playing as well as you'd like, if you can win the first game, it gives you a little momentum. And often on the road, after you've been struggling like we have, you're a little more relaxed. Maybe it's just not playing in front of the hometown that you're trying to win the games and please at the same time. So for us, we have to look at this one as being the most important, because it's also against the divisional opponent. So it would be a nice start to this trip to win tonight.
Thank you. this was a loss you had during a stretch of games when you were playing pretty well, you could say, well, you know, the puck wasn't rolling for us tonight, but that's an old story for the Canucks, and we're all getting a little sick of it, so I guess it's just something that we've had to contend with the whole year, and it's cost us a lot of hockey games, or whatever it is.
One down, four to go with the remaining 7 days on the road. Now what?
Well, we will practice Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and they'll be about 60-minute practices, and perhaps not as strenuous as some we'd have if we were on a homestand with 2 and 3 days between games, but I don't think with our playing, for instance, that it's tiring to play 5 games and 8 nights in 5 different cities, but we'll have workouts those days, and if we've got injured players or players that have been playing a lot, they might be excused or get a light practice, but it won't change very much from the way we've been going at home.
The players aren't the only benefactors of Air Canuck.
And we never have to tag the baggage. We go right to the airport. We don't have to be at the airport early like we used to for a commercial flight. So it has much more advantages. And then as far as, say, if a player is injured during the game, it's much easier to ice the person, you know, get ice bags on them on the plane, opposed to flying commercially or whatever. So it's much nicer this way.
35%.
Vancouver, far west, you got a bad traveling schedule. With this plane, it helps out a lot, and I think the main thing it helps out is the wait over. Say when we used to fly commercially, you'd have to wait 2 hours in Chicago and this stuff. And then it also eliminates crowded planes and everything. You got a lot of room and stuff. But one thing I'd like to mention is everybody's getting on our case since we've had this plane because they say we're spoiled or not. I don't think the plane's got anything to do with it. We're winning or losing. It's a nice thing to have, and we really appreciate it from the Griffiths family. It's very nice from them. But I don't like to think people are coming down on us because we have a plane all of a sudden. I think we're still trying as hard, and hopefully we can turn things around.
Just as the days of the week mean little, if anything, neither do the attractions of the 20 opposition cities. And it's almost a shame with the likes of the annual Quebec Winter Carnival in progress. The ice sculpture is but one of the many facets of the culture of one of Canada's most unique cities. But part of our history, the Plains of Abraham, are moments away. But some of the finest wine cellars, restaurants, or any of a host of unique attractions are at their disposal, would only be of interest if several days off were available. Being oblivious to it is to be patient for when there is time, and to be more cognizant of the business at hand. The refurbished Colisée, home of the Nordiques, is akin to the Montreal Forum for hockey atmosphere. And it's here, and now, the clock is punched.
Thank you.
A victory is a great tonic, greater still when on the road. But while a slump has been snapped, immediate thoughts are more simple than savoring the win. The midnight flight to Montreal requires expediency by everybody with everything. But at least bumps and bruises are more palatable.
They'll love that.
This is it. The corner of St. Catherine Street and Atwater in Montreal. 19 Stanley Cup pennants. The atmosphere of the Forum is as intimidating as it is awesome. Perhaps it's because the Canucks have recorded but four regular season victories here that some moods are stoic. Then again, a win the previous night on the road provides that effervescence of confidence even here.
That one time I was first star in this building.
You got first star in here?
First star in this building.
You are that the US
two goals, three assists, plus three. That's going back 1978.
The seven Canadian NHL cities are home and close to it for the majority of players. But when you're a rookie, and it's in Quebec.
Yeah, it's for me, it puts a lot of pressure because that's my hometown, and that's pretty tough for me. Before the game, I was very nervous. And so right when I go right on the ice in my first shift, everything is gone, and I play a pretty good game against Quebec. And so all the players play well, and we forecheck everybody, and especially against Stastny. So we play a pretty good game, and I hope to get going for a lot of game. So I would like to beat Montreal too, because I know when I was young, I watched Quebec and Montreal, and Montreal was my favorite team. And now I play against him, and I would like to beat Montreal.
The Forum tingles the spine of not only players, but also friends and relatives. The interested spectator at this practice is the proud father, Jean-Marc Lanthier, watching his son for the first time as a pro on Forum ice.
I started to skate, I was three, and he was the one who taught me how to skate, and after that he was my coach, and my he always followed me, and I'm very proud of that, so I try to do my best for him tomorrow. I'm always nervous before a game, even if it's Montreal or Quebec or anywhere, but tomorrow I think it's going to be more butterflies, and when the game will start, it's all gone after that. For me, it's the first time I'm gonna play in the Forum Pro. I play four games here, but never pro. And with the Canucks, all my family will be here, and that's gonna be a big trip for me, because I always follow the Canadian, Montreal Canadian, since I was a little boy. And now I'm gonna play against them, Lafleur, and he was my idol, so I'm gonna play against him tomorrow, so that's gonna be a big thrill for me.
This game between the Canucks and the Montreal Canadiens is underway from the Forum in Montreal.
Lots of shots, guys. Lots of shots from this guy. Fuego. 1 minute here. 1 good minute.
We're in the last minute of the first period. The Canucks score. Patrick Sundstrom makes it 1-0.
Wait, that's the way. It's the way. Where you go? Williamson. Right, Rota.
finishes and we reproached the Montreal for Auckland. Evans to come at Montreal for Senti le bon suivi à Peter. Les sabres de bon sous seront les visiteurs. Jersey de French Fibri à
some games in the road will do for you, and we haven't done it at all yet this year, and we've won, you know, two games. We haven't done that for a long time, and it brings the morale up a lot, I tell you, and I think you can know it and you can feel it when you're walking around, when the guys that are practicing and on the day offs we have. It's a nice feeling, and you know, you got to have that feeling. If you want to be a winner, you got to win on the road.
The way they were playing, I felt certainly we could come back and beat them. I mean, they were not doing much of a job, but I didn't feel our team really felt strongly about it. And maybe that was good. They just kept playing and it worked.
I think that's the most exciting moment of my life because it's in my town, and I feel very great tonight.
You'd have to be part of it if you don't believe it all the time that's been said or written, but a key part of the team is the trainer, and even Ken Flager has a game day ritual.
Looking good. First, I come down early in the morning and sharpen the skates, and then they skate on them in the morning at 11:30 on the road, and after that, I have about four more pair to do. There's about four guys like a new edge, for the game, like, and then after that we just straighten it all out after their morning skate, and give them clean underwear for the night, put their sweaters up, check the socks for holes, and just have it all nice and neat for them when they come in for the game.
The boss of the dressing room is always the head trainer, not the coach or captain, and in Larry Ashley they have a veteran well versed medically and obviously well prepared.
As far as equipment and supplies, I carry all my own. As far as I carry ultrasound, I carry a galvanic stimulator, I carry a TENS unit, then all of my medical supplies, tapes and liniments and chemicals and that. And then if we need a whirlpool or whatever, we have to use the home team's facilities. So I'm able to get by with my own facility, my own supplies when I'm on the road.
Well, I think these last two wins we had in the La Belle province, La Fleur-de-Lis, we had to come up with and show us that, you know, we could come up with a win, because we were lower, really low. And we couldn't afford to lose any more games. So, same with these next two games. We got to win for sure one out of these next two games.
Losses are bitter enough in their own right. Salt in the wound is an arduous hour and a half bus ride to the airport of Newark, New Jersey. More still, thanks to fog causing a further wait of an hour and ultimately cancellation of the flight, thus scrambling for a hotel and eventually game day travel with who else but the Flyers to form the welcoming committee.
Before we got our plane, we would have been fogged in the morning and not had a plane to leave our luggage on. And I think when you're on a trip like this, the plane enters into it and makes an uncomfortable situation quite tolerable. So we can't use that as an excuse. And we talked about that before the game, but I guess we got those penalties right away and we never had a chance to get much going. But a lot of good play on this road trip, and 6 out of 8 points, we'll take it at any time.
Round Trip with the Vancouver Canucks was brought to you tonight by Molson, Canada's name in beer since 1786, brewers of Molson Light. Now stay tuned. Coming up next, the Vancouver Canucks host the Chicago Blackhawks at the Pacific Coliseum. Another presentation of the NHL on BC TV.
On BC TV.